This has been a very important part of my work, and the removals were an experience by itself for me and the participants. By doing this, we restore the human body back to the way it was in Lemurian times. This allows for the original 12D divine blueprint and many of our strands of DNA to come fully into action when they are being activated. This allows also for a higher light integration inside the physical and energy bodies, which is needed for planetary and or cosmic ascension. The J seals will prevent you from completing full planetary and or cosmic ascension. Some of the experiences were, I am still blown away by the high energies. I feel so much energy running through my body, we are all just enjoying being in the energies. I feel very light, like a weight has lifted of me. There is much that can be said about these J seals. My experience is that these seals prevent you from fully allowing yourself to move into the higher dimensions and anchor the higher dimensional energies within you. They can have an effect on the physical body, resulting in pain in certain areas. You can see the list below for where each seal is within the body. Removing these seals, and I have done hundreds of them, has been very liberating for many people. Some were completely without pain, others had many veils removed to be able to see clearer, but the most important one has been that the energy coming from your own being starts to flow through you in a greater amount. This is one of the most important things you can do for yourself. I would suggest that after you have these seals removed, get a cosmic axial alignment as well. This will allow for the full amount of your being to start flowing. It will repair all axial energy lines within the physical and spiritual bodies that are active at this moment. Tilde. The seven Jehovian seals. The seven Jehovian seals were placed in the Earth's planetary shield about 200,000 years ago. They were placed around the same time as the 12 star crystal seals. The star crystal seals were placed in preparation for the Earth's ascension in this time period. The Jehovian seals were placed to interfere with this process. They ride on the frequency being brought in by releasing the star crystal seals and start distorting these higher frequencies. Six of the Jehovian seals have been activated at this time. The 12 star crystal seals are connected to the 12 universal stargate portals, and once all of them are activated, they will allow for the axiatinal lines in the Earth's grid to be activated and a Merkaba will be built for the Earth. When a star crystal seal and stargate portal connect, it will allow for higher frequencies to be released into the Earth's dimension. It allows for a blending within the Earth's dimensions and connecting above with below. The distortion created by the Jehovian seals has damaged out Earth's planetary shield. This shield resides on the outer limits of our universe. At this point in time, the shield has been significantly damaged and a new shield has been brought into place just inside of Earth's planetary shield, but it is not activated yet. Once all 12 portals are opened, it will allow for this shield to be activated. Six of the Jehovian seals have been activated in the Earth's planetary shield and in our own physical body, since we are connected to the energy of the Earth's planetary shield. In the times before the fall, some 200,000 years ago, humans were not dying. They would simply ascend from the density on Earth and leave through the universal stargate portals. In those days, there were 12 angelic human tribes appointed to carry the original planetary Templar complex. These human angelic tribes were the guardians of this planetary Templar complex. Each tribe was holding 1/12 of the Emerald Covenant, and each tribe was divided into 12 groups, each holding 1/12 of the 1/12 of the Emerald Covenant. The Emerald Covenant held the original divine blueprint for Earth's ascension and our ascension. It has the ability to complete all activations that are needed to ascend the Earth and the human that choose to ascend with the Earth. For over 11,000 years, humans and Illuminati were denied the truth and the history of all this. They have been destroying each other on behalf of the fallen races outside of our universe. The sacred teachings of the 12 tribes are hidden among all religions. So the 12 star crystal seals open us up to a higher frequency. The Jehovian seals are distorting this frequency. Since we have seven Jehovian seals inside the human body, We are not able to fully integrate the higher frequencies, and what we integrate is distorted and out of balance. The distortion of the frequencies also had its effect on the planetary shield and created holes that unbalance the energies even more, influencing our weather and the tectonic plates of the Earth. The Illuminati have chosen to work with the Zetas instead of the Emerald Covenant nations, preventing us from knowing about this and preventing us from doing repairs here from the Earth itself. The Emerald Covenant nations have been sending in energies that can assist us in balancing the distortions, and these energies are being anchored on Earth. The opening of the Stargate portals allows for more energies to be sent in at this time. The Zetas represent several groups that are there only for the sole purpose of controlling the Earth and use it for their purposes. Six of these Jehovian seals have been activated and are influencing every human being on Earth at this time. They prevent us from completely activating our DNA and restore our original divine blueprint in the physicals and spiritual bodies. They will allow for just enough activation to make you feel like you are making progress, but they will prevent full activation. Since the opening of the star gates and the securing of these gates, we have been able to receive more energies that are stabilizing the energies in our dimensions. This allows for a different approach in removing the J-seals, Jehovian seals, at this time. We are ahead of schedule, so the knowledge on releasing these J-seals in a different and faster way has been given to us. This knowledge is protected under the seal of Isis, as to not have interference while removing these J-seals from humans at this time. As you might understand, we cannot remove the J-seals from the Earth, as we cannot interfere with the process of releasing the star crystal seals. The Jehovian seals are energetically connected to activate when a star crystal seal is released. We can, however, prevent these seals from affecting us as humans in our ascension process. The removal of the J-seals is very delicate and requires more than just removal. Once enough humans are without J-seals, we will be able to start repairing the Earth's planetary shield at this time, so we will be able to stabilize the energy in our dimensions, which will allow for a more balanced and peaceful road toward the ascension. How did humanity inherit unnatural seals? All human beings are born with energetic distortions in the human body known as unnatural seals, as they were not created by Source, God. According to Voyagers 2 by Ashiana Dean, fallen intruder races known as the Jehovian and Anunnaki created ancient implants in the Earth's grids. Since humans share an energetic connection with the Earth, we inherit these distortions at birth. These distortions affect your genetic structure and your ability to ascend. If holes are poked in the Earth, those holes are poked in you. These seals literally manifest death and have created a cycle of death and reincarnation for millions of years. What are the unnatural seals? These distortions or energetic implants are 7J seals or Jehovian seals, Metatronic implants, Templar seal, Templar Axion seal, cell death programs, apoptosis, crown of thorns, and Zeta seal. The 7J seals or death seals are located into the Earth's grid. The seals are located as follows. J seal 1, top of skull on left side. J seal 2, heart, left lung, back of left knee. J seal 3, pineal gland. J seal 4, left side of neck and lymphatics. J seal 5, rear left thigh and buttocks. J seal 6, alta major, where skull rests atop the spine, hypothalamus, and left shoulder. J seal 7, aorta artery on left side of neck. The J seals, Jehovian and Anunnaki seals, are unnatural implants in the multidimensional anatomy of humans that prevent the DNA from activating properly. They are located on axiatinal line 7 of the Earth and the human energetic anatomy. The significance of the J-seals is that we inherit these from the Earth's grids. They are unnatural, as is the death that they cause. Biological transmutation, ascension, is built into the original angelic human DNA template, and the J-seals and specifically the Zeta seal prevents this. Everyone on the planet has the J-seals, and it is the most important session you can do. The J seals, Jehovian seals, are referred also as the death seals and are located at the planetary level. All beings have these seals. Since the Earth and our bodies are built the same energetically, and they share certain energetic connections and we inherit these Jehovian seals at birth. They are located on the left side of the body. The removal of J seal is a distant healing session where we remove the 7 unnatural J seals. These seals may manifest disease in their respective locations. Common experiences after the session are the ability to breathe better, back, neck and knee problems dissipate, better connection to higher self and more psychic skills noticed, better circulation, and the ability to reach higher states such as bliss and unconditional love. These sessions are very important right now. The Jehovian seals or J-seals were created and implanted on the Earth's grids by the Jehovian Anunnaki race. Humans share an energetic connection with the Earth via axiatinal lines. As a result of this connection, we inherit at birth the distortions created by the seals. These distortions affect our genetic structure and our ability to ascend. Anything that affects the Earth affects humanity, just like anything which happens to a mother carrying a child in her womb affects the child. We are within the womb of Mother Earth. The Earth has 12 axiatinal vertical energy lines around the globe. The seals are located on axiatinal line 7. This corresponds to the left side of the human body. These seals potentially manifest death and have been called the death seals. The original angelic human DNA template was inbuilt for biological transmutation. This meant that the body would not die but turn into light or a less dense form when ready to ascend. Additionally, the original angelic human DNA 12-strand template called the Diamond Sun template was meant to activate as follows. Between the ages 12-22 strands 4-6, which corresponds to your soul identity, would automatically be activated. Between the ages of 23-33, strands 7-9, which corresponds to your oversoul identity, would automatically be activated. Between the ages of 33-44, strands 10-12, which corresponds to your Christos avatar self, would automatically be activated. Due to distortions on the Earth's planetary grids as well as distortions in our DNA template, the DNA cannot activate automatically. The original organic imprint for health was disturbed. The J seals and other implants and seals I speak of below are in part responsible for the DNA distortions. If the J seals are not cleared from one's energetic anatomy, the body can experience progressive deterioration. These seals are the reason why so many people experience physical discomfort or disease on the left side of their body. The removal of the seals can for some people result in instant healing of the pained area. Some of my clients who have had neck issues have had either an instant healing of that area or within a few days of the seals being removed. Additionally, the removal for the seals impacts positively on the activation of the DNA strands. As you know, the Earth is currently in a stellar activation cycle, ascension cycle. During this cycle, the planet's primary energy vortices, equivalent to our chakras, open up in preparation for the incoming stellar spirals. The J seals block the frequencies from being integrated, and instead, cause them to function in the reverse sequences, resulting in the activation of black holes within the planetary and personal energetic fields. Because of these blockages, the higher frequency wave infusions now reaching the planet are not being integrated by many people or not being sufficiently integrated. This is also the reason why many people are experiencing great physical discomfort at this time. It is through the integration of higher dimensional energies that we are able to clear the distortions in our lower physical/emotional/mental ego mind and align with higher dimensions. Apart from the J seals, there are other implants and seals which affect our DNA template. These seals and energetic implants also include metatronic implants, Templar seal, Templar axion seal, cell death programs, apoptosis, crown of thorns, and the Zeta seal. Metatronic implants are known as the tree of artificial life. They are a series of implants designed to rapidly reverse the activating template into metatronic fall. It is the reverse shadow body as opposed to the ascending, evolving 12-dimensional body. Metatron was an entity that fell due to code convolution. The Metatronic structure sucks energy to be immortal. Templar Seal and Templar Axe on Seal involved the removal of the 6th base tone of DNA strand 2, the 6th overtone from strand 4 and the 12th overtone of strand 5 in the 6th dimension. In the 7th dimension, it involved the removal of the 6th base tone of the 1st DNA strand, the 6th base tone of the 5th strand, and the 6th base tone of the 6th DNA strand. This is the original meaning of the biblical reference to 666. It is the reason why humanity has been asleep, buried in religion's persuasive story of a wrathful, judgment-oriented God, unable to integrate higher frequencies for ascension. Cell death programs is apoptosis, what science terms as cells committing suicide. Science believes apoptosis is normal, but it was never intended by Source, God, for us to die and reincarnate. Cell death programs has shortened humanity's lifespan and kept humanity incarnating. The crown of thorns is an energy configuration above the head of humans that distorts the natural energetic circulatory system and blocks the receiving of the primal life force currents from your higher self and Source, God. The crucifixion was an energetic crucifixion to humanity, as the crown of thorns scrambles the universal currents to our chakras, keeping humanity stuck in a third dimensional frequency fence. Once this is cleared, many feel or see a metal plate being removed from above their head. Zeta Seal is located in the 4th DNA strand, which blocks a person's ability to evolve towards frequencies of unconditional love and higher dimensions. The 5th DNA strand is blocked from plugging into any of the lower strands. It's a frequency fence. All beings born since 1748 AD have this Zeta Seal distortion. It has created a blockage from experiencing astral awareness, astral travel, lucid dreaming, out-of-body experiences, intuitive gifts, and causing difficulty in remembering dreams. Original Divine Template. The original divine template for human progression was a natural unfolding of higher consciousness in one lifetime. For example, at age 12 your soul body would be activated, which corresponds to DNA strands 4, 5, and 6. At the age of 22, your oversoul body would be activated, which corresponds to DNA strands 7, 8, and 9 would activate. At the age of 33, your Christos avatar body would be activated, which corresponds to the activation of DNA strands 10, 11, and 12. By the age of 44, your Rishi body would be activated, which corresponds to DNA strands 13, 14, and 15. This natural process is the embodiment of one's higher consciousness, also known as ascension. Since the majority of humanity is unable to activate strand 4 during adolescence, the chemicals back up in the DNA, creating all kinds of weird emotional issues and physical imbalances. This is not natural. Strand 4 never gets activated, and thus a person never activates their soul identity. Thus they have no idea why they incarnated here, what they are here to do, and cannot even connect to and listen to their higher self because their 7 higher senses are not active. If these unnatural seals are not cleared, then biological death is inevitable. Yet biological death is not natural to our angelic human DNA or indigo DNA templates. We are meant to biologically ascend, which is the accretion of light to transform the body into light, not drop the body and leave it behind. This sounds too weird and unbelievable. It is easy to understand why a person would be skeptical of something they cannot see with their physical eyes. I have learned it over the course of my life to trust my intuition, as my intuition and feelings have always been correct. Sometimes what we see is opposite of what we feel. For example, your partner may tell you that he or she honors sexual fidelity in your relationship, yet you feel this is a lie. Why? A person can lie, but their energy will always tell the truth. When you use your inward wisdom, you are connecting to this energy signal that speaks the truth. Michael Talbot explains in his book The Holographic Universe, we are perceivers. We are an awareness. We are not objects. We have no solidity. We are boundless. The world of objects and solidity is a way of making our passage on Earth convenient. Even if unnatural seals clearing sounds odd, trust your intuition, for we are perceivers. The unnatural seal removal session is extremely important and a must for human evolution, as it helps to restore your original organic imprint for health. There are 7 unnatural seals located on the left side of the human body. The J seals are also known as death seals, and are 7 anchoring rods, placed in Earth's planetary shields, specifically one vertical column, horizontally across from certain natural configurations in Earth's grids called star crystal seals. These seals cause degeneration and many physical, mental and emotional problems. It is important to understand that the Earth and our bodies are built energetically the same way, and that we are directly connected to the Earth. Since the seals exist in the Earth's grids, we inherit these into our own grids. So everyone on Earth has these 7 seals in their bodies. There have been many, many cataclysms in Earth's history that have affected us, and this is what has reduced our lifespan, brain function, and spiritual awareness. Did you ever notice that most problems are on the left side of a person's body? Well, this is why. These seals are located as follows in the body. Seal 1, top of the skull on the left side. Seal 2, heart, left lung, back left knee. Seal 3, pineal gland. Seal 4, left side of neck and lymphatics. Seal 5, rear left thigh and buttock. Seal 6, ulna major, where skull rests atop the spine, hypothalamus, and top of left shoulder. Seal 7, aorta artery on left side of neck. If you have been having problems in the above areas in the last 4-5 years, it may be due to the seals. One of the most important seals to remove is the one in the pineal gland, as this blocks the natural activation of the pineal and prevents one from accessing their higher levels of consciousness. This is the main reason most people have limited psychic skills and cannot connect to their higher self. Before an understanding of this work can be had, one must realize and be aware of the fact that extraterrestrial races have been involved with the course of evolution on this planet since life was seeded many millions of years ago. This involvement includes both benevolent guardianship and malevolent interference from self-interested races. As a result of this intervention, humanity have had to integrate many genetic alterations which are now present in nearly all genetic lineages. A study of the pre-ancient history of Earth and an understanding of multidimensional anatomy is required to more completely understand how this affects us in today's world. Below is a brief introduction as to how these blockages have come about and what it means for us as individuals. Additionally, this information is not meant to scare anyone. It is simply intended to bring awareness to the greater reality that we exist within, and thereby empower individuals to make conscious choices in line with their highest good and freedom. The Templar and Templar Axion seals are 6th and 7th dimensional genetic alterations implemented 10,000 and 3,500 years ago, respectively, by the Ra Confederacy, Ammonite and Azurite Gestalt families, and the Axios entity family, in order to protect the Earth and Terra from unevolved beings ascending through the halls of Amenti Stargate portals to the higher harmonics. The Templar seals have been passed on genetically over time and now affect the majority of the population, making physical ascension impossible. More specifically, the Templar seal involved the removal of the 6th base tone of DNA strand 2. The 6th overtone from strand 4 and the 12th overtone of strand 5, which created massive distortions within the astral, mental and emotional bodies, locking consciousness into the D3 time cycles of Hu1. In short, for biological transmutation, ascension, to take place, we require to braid the 12 magnetic base tones with the 12 electrical overtones within each DNA strand, corresponding to the dimensional frequencies we are inhabiting, and this results in an upfolding of the physical form to then reappear in the next harmonic. If there are fragments of the DNA base magnetic and electrical overtones missing, this is not possible. A qualitative way to consider this is by comparing it to the way we do up a zip. If there is one section of the zip missing, this will result in the two tracks dividing and not braiding together properly. If the genetic zip cannot be done up, we cannot complete the integration of dimensions 1, 2 and 3 of Hulun and therefore must remain locked in this time continuum. Genetic manipulations can be undertaken by advanced races whom are aware of the workings of the energetic grid system of the Earth. Because we are all connected to this system as we live on the Earth, these manipulations are automatically transferred to our own energy fields and personal energetic anatomy when we are born. The seventh dimensional Templar Axion Seal, of 1-500 BC, involved the removal of the sixth base tone of the first DNA strand, the sixth base tone of the fifth strand and the sixth base tone of the sixth DNA strand. This is the original meaning of the symbolic 666, number of the beast, in that genetic codes carrying this distortion cannot assemble their DNA adequately to qualify for the next harmonic universe. This is one of the reasons why so many people are not waking up during this ascension cycle. People who have had these seals energetically removed can then begin to rapidly integrate the higher dimensional frequencies of the higher harmonics in preparation for biological transmutation and ascension during the current stellar activation cycle, SAC, of 2000 to 2017 AD, peaking between 2012 to 2017 AD. This information became distorted into the religious dogma of a judgmental God and that we would be punished for our sins, yet this was only ever a confused distortion of the truth. We must remain incarnate within the first harmonic universal experiences, which include war, pain, suffering, etc., hell, until we have evolved our consciousness sufficiently to align with the second harmonic, truth, love and wisdom. If you are drawn to this information and resonate to it, this indicates you are ready to continue through to the second harmonic universe and ascension. People still working through the lower three-dimensional reality fields of Earth, physical, emotional and mental bodies, may not resonate to this understanding because the intuitive astral body connection, fourth DNA strand integration requires to be active to understand the meaning of this and therefore feel aligned with it. Everyone is evolving as they are meant to be according to their conscious evolution, so if you do not resonate to this information, we do not desire to convince anyone otherwise. Things simply are as they are, and people still locked in the third dimensional mental body, ego, will likely have to remain here until a higher understanding and acceptance has been made. The Zeta Seal is a deliberate interference in the course of our evolution to serve the needs of the collective Zeta mind. The Zeta Grays from the Zeta Reticuli, neighboring star system to Orion, are primarily responsible for the human abductions and cattle mutilations which have been occurring and documented by researchers for many years now. The Zeta are a fragmented race that span many dimensions and which have both enlightened factions and unenlightened factions, meaning some who respect and honor the evolution of other races and others who do not. There is far too much information to cover regarding the Zeta motive, but in short, they feel they need our planet to continue their own evolution because they destroyed their own home planet through interdimensional blending experiments that were beyond their understanding to undertake. They have been instigative in such things as the Philadelphia Project and the Montauk Project here on Earth to serve their agenda, unbeknownst to the Secret Service governmental officials they have been manipulating. Of significance to us as individuals is the genetic mutation, Zeta Seal, which all people, unless they have had it removed, currently have expressing in their energetic physiology in some way. This genetic manipulation, introduced in 1748 AD, involved the removal of the second base tone and second and third overtones of the fourth DNA strand, which created a hidden frequency fence on Earth since 1748. The result of this has been that people have been unable to access their soul identity, higher self, intuitive body, which would otherwise serve to direct them along a more favorable pathway of choices in their lives. This is also one of the main reasons why people are not waking up and recognizing what is transpiring on Earth right now. As a result of this interference, the sleeping masses continue their lives completely unaware of the cosmic events unfolding around them as they remain focused within the three-dimensional reality fields of Huan. In 1902, Guardian Alliance, benevolent ET races, began poking holes in the Zeta mind control frequency fence by activating certain individuals in the population, essentially reversing this genetic blockage. Since then, this released collective have been gaining momentum through higher light work to awaken the remaining dormant population. When a minimum of 8% of the population, critical mass, have successfully activated their fourth DNA strand, this will result in an energetic override of the Zeta seal in the planetary grids, which will result in an awakening within in the greater collective, in which case the dawn of a new age, the golden age of enlightenment, will occur for humanity. We are not at this stage yet, however, and require to, as individuals, undertake sufficient light work and DNA activation to contribute to the momentum of light for the greater good of the all. The seven unnatural Jehovian death seals, or J seals, are energetic implants that were placed in the Earth's energetic anatomy, which can be activated by the Nibiruian diodic crystal grid network, which interfaces via access point at Stonehenge, in 24-500 BC by Jehovian Anunnaki from the planet Nibiru. This planet is on a 3,600-year orbital cycle around our Sun and therefore only comes into visibility and interaction with the Earth every 3,600 years. There are records of this interaction in ancient Sumerian tablets, carved in stone. This information has been translated and validated by modern academic scholars. To understand how this affects us on a personal level, we require to understand the processes a planet goes through during stellar activation cycles. During sacs, the planet's primary energy vortices, equivalent to our chakras, open up as the stellar wave infusions from other galactic and universal locations align with the Earth. If these energy vortices or stargates cannot open correctly, then the planet cannot integrate the incoming higher frequency energies from the higher dimensional locations and therefore, not ascend out of the current harmonic. It is through the integration of higher dimensional energies that we are able to clear the distortions in our lower physical/emotional/mental ego mind and align with these higher locations. It is not within the Anunnaki agenda to allow the planet to ascend, because as soon as humanity has transitioned into Hutu, we will no longer be within the frequency bands that would allow their manipulation. As to the details of what that is, the manipulation, this is far too much to include here in this short summary, so if you are interested, you are encouraged to do your own research regarding this. What is relevant for us is the energetic implants that have been placed in the Earth's energetic anatomy and therefore, our energetic anatomy if we were born on the Earth. There is likely not too many people who can say this do not include them. These implants were placed along axiatinal line number 7 of the planetary grid, which corresponds to energy vortices, planetary templar, 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 10 and 11. As their planetary energy vortices open up in preparation for the incoming stellar spirals, these seals block the frequencies from being integrated and instead cause them to function in the reverse sequences, resulting in the activation of black holes within the planetary and personal energetic fields. There are far-reaching consequences for such a thing to occur, which will not be covered here, but needless to say that we should clear these distortions as many people as possible ASAP. Because of these blockages, the higher frequency wave infusions now reaching the planet are not being integrated by many people. The D4 solar wave infusion started May 5, 2000, with the D5 Pleiadian and D6 Sirian infusions starting 6/2004 and 6/2008 respectively. The D7 Arcturian, D8 Orion and D9 Andromeda infusions are still yet to come, although if our energetic physiology is not equipped to integrate these frequencies, this will result in progressive molecular compaction, which is one of the reasons why pain and disease continues to be on the rise. If you have health issues along the left of your body, this may be related to the J-seal blockages along axiatinal line 7, which runs vertically along the parasagittal axis of the left-hand side of the body. J seals are embodied death seals. The Jehovian seals or J-seals were energetically and maliciously placed by the Jehovian Anunnaki on the Earth Ataxiatinal Line 7 as distortions in the Earth's energy grid system. Since Earth and our energetic anatomies are identical, we inherit anything that happens to the Earth at the time of conception. When we do a J-seal removal session, our energetic anatomy is directly connected to the Earth, so when we clear ourselves, we also clear that area of the Earth. Every human on Earth has these seals until they are cleared. J-seals are located on the left side of the body and when in place, cause much needless pain and suffering in those same regions of the body until they are removed. These unnatural seals block the activation of the fourth DNA strand, which is why the DNA stops activating past the third strand, keeping us locked into third-dimensional consciousness and typically manifests as physical, mental and emotional disease, especially in the regions where these seals are located on the left side of the body. These unnatural J-seals block higher-dimensional frequencies coming into the body and greatly inhibits the expansion of our consciousness. While present in the physical body, our ego mind remains locked in third-dimensional frequencies and limited to those frequencies until the J-seals are removed. Removal of the J-seals is an integral part of clearing and preparing the physical body for ascension during this current ascension cycle from 2012 to 2019, as well as enabling the ability to fully embody our higher selves. J-seals manifest physical death and are the reason our bodies only live to be 70-80 years of age versus the 900 or so years people lived in Bible times. Immortality cannot be achieved when the death seals are in place and are humanity's biggest handicap. Science says it is normal to age as polymers shrink. That is not the truth and aging is not normal. We as divine beings of light and love were never created or intended to age. Even ascension is based on your frequency and your DNA level of activation. Ascension does not happen naturally, contrary to many New Agers who state otherwise without the full understanding of this serious phenomenon. Removing J seals and all other unnatural seals is the most important thing we can each do for ourselves and Earth, which in turn helps all of humanity, for as we heal and evolve, as does everything else. Some people have heard about this and I have known about them for a long time. Before the shift there didn't really seem to be a need to remove them as they relate more to experiences within higher dimensions above the third dimension. So in reality there wasn't really a need to remove them until the Earth frequency moved or started to include the fifth dimensional frequency. I have had more people ask about this, so it is time to remove them and allow the higher dimensional frequencies more fully enter and integrate in the physical reality. The crown of thorns will remind many of the crown of thorns that was placed in the head of Jesus. It is an energy implant that is around the head, specifically to prevent the pineal gland to be fully cleared and activated, and in this way preventing the third eye from fully being opened for many. Even if the third eye is fully opened, it will not work at its fullest as the pineal gland will not fully activate. Metatronic implants are mostly within the energy bodies and are connected into a larger grid of implants that have been around Earth for a long time. They were placed even before the J-seals and have a different influence than what many do expect. The name metatronic is in reality not the name for these implants, as they are at a crystal frequency and prevent many energy bodies from fully reconnecting as well as fully integrating and merging within the human physical body. Human have many what I would call veils within them that hook them into holographic realities instead of the real spiritual reality, and this is what metatronic implants are meant to do. This is why they are connected into a larger grid, what many would call the matrix. Death seals are in reality more frequencies that run through many of the energy bodies connected to the physical body that keep the death state, incarnation belief in the human reality. It is a small grid system running through the energy bodies connected to the physical body. The emotional, mental bodies are mostly part of this. In this way the grid runs also through the physical body, keeping the cells within the physical body in a reminder of the need to deteriorate to complete the incarnation process that is present for each human body. Dimensional limitation switches are lined up along the spine and prevent you from fully integrating any energy that is higher than the third dimensional frequency. You can still experience and get a feeling of the higher frequencies, and most have, but many also have the feeling of falling down again, or moving back and forth between the dimensions, as these switches do not allow for a full merging of the third dimensional reality with any higher experience of reality. Removing all of this will have a different effect on each person, as we are all having and going through certain experiences and feelings of dimensional realities. I can only explain what it meant for me, as I have gone through these removals several years ago. For me, it was an opening that allowed me to further and more fully integrate my higher parts, part of my higher being, and receive the energies connected to that into the physical body. It still takes time to fully integrate and merge with those higher parts, but there is no blockage anymore to connect and do this. For many who have already gone through many integrations, it will remove restrictions of belief systems that are still ingrained within us even after all the clearings, activations and integrations that we have gone through. These removals have an effect on the human mind and brain, as it is learning to understand the spiritual reality and seeing clearly the motives that are behind what many call the dark, as well as seeing the limitations we have as humans as we experience more of the spiritual reality and try to use the human brain to translate. No matter what you experience, all I can say is that it is time, the earth and the energy upon earth, as well as we as humans adjusting to the change upon earth, has settled a bit, and I feel the time for the removal is now for many. Removal can have a physical impact as well for some people, as it might relieve some of the physical symptoms that many experience when integrating or being within higher frequencies. As well as some of these have a physical impact that might seem more like a regular pain that keeps coming back. Muscle pain is one of the most common ones. Slight headaches in the forehead are sometimes felt as well. I am not a doctor, so I cannot say these removals will in fact assist with those pains, as it is sometimes hard to say if they have a physical or energetic origin. All I can say, they might. Sometimes the removal will uncover other implants, so keep an eye on that, and I will watch for that during the removal, although they sometimes do not show up until the energies have balanced. This is all from my own experience with removal of these implant devices and grids, and I want to be clear about what it can do, but mostly what it might do, as I cannot with certainty say what it will do. I have noticed after checking my own energies that even though I removed everything several years ago, there are still some remnants that were present. This is due to the fact that it was done before the shift, and the new energies that we are now surrounded by have brought them into action. I have seen this before, and there still might be some other remnants, but what I always do is a regular check of my energies to see if anything has to be removed or can be removed, even though I know I already worked on it before. For those of you that had your J seals removed through others, we will have a check and see if everything is removed. I see a lot of people out there doing removals with special coatings and stuff like that. In reality, J seals are not removed with saying or bringing in certain coatings, and most only remove the seals and not the energy lines that actually keep the seals in place, as most are not capable of seeing them energetically and rely upon their coatings to remove the seals. The energy lines, if they stay in place, can either bring the seals back or still bring in interference, as they still receive energy or frequencies of the seals that were removed and put I don't know where. What we do is in fact destroy them. The energy that is the J seals is being transformed, but this can only be done if you can actually see them and know how to transform it. Many times the ascended masters will assist us with these clearings, and I am always present to really make sure that everything is removed. One more thing I always forget, usually when you sign up for something like this, the work will begin even before the removal. Reason for this is that some it requires some preparation work to make it easier to do the removal. So if you already feel some work happening, this is why. To read the entire document, click on the link in the description.